So, the doctors refused to be talked into giving any information about my mystery illness. They said that because they were still running tests, it was far too early to guess where the illness had come from, or how long it would take to find a vaccine. Well, those media guys weren't too happy about that. So they all rushed off to write their stories and blogs without waiting for the facts. And you can imagine how that turned out. By this time, I was isolated in a ward, with tubes stuck in my arms and up my nose, and all sorts of electronic gadgets connected to me. The test results showed that I had a particularly horrible bacterial infection. All they could do was pump my body full of antibiotics and leave the rest up to my immune system. They told my mum and dad that I was fighting for my life. They both started crying then. I'm glad I wasn't awake to see that. Mind you, my dad is always the first to cry when there's something sad on the TV. But back to the story. So as I lay unconscious, the fight for my life was happening inside of me.